Hi guys, good afternoon from Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. As promised, we have our stocks by request happening right now. Sorry that we're doing it at the end of the week, but it was relatively a shortened trading week. No, we just had three trading days of stocks, primarily because of the holiday that we had on Tuesday and Wednesday as well. So let's give you a couple of minutes for you guys to join us and start to log into the stocks by request session. And while we're actually doing that as well, I'd like to invite you guys tomorrow na yun, Stock Sports Malaysia, if you guys are from the Kuala Lumpur area, if you guys are from Malaysia, or you guys have friends here in Kuala Lumpur, it would be very nice of you. It would be nice to meet all of you tomorrow as we talk a lot about technical analysis as well. And then we'll be in Sydney, Australia next week for Stock Smarts Australia naman. So it's an honor to be part of all of you guys, your journey towards financial freedom. And I really do hope that the stock market is an avenue for you to be able to hit your goals of financial freedom. So that's it. Ayan, we now have people who are joining us right now. You have Deanna's asking for tugs. Please, if you're joining us for the first time, please note what city or what area are you from, so that I know how many, from what cities are you guys represented from. Then you have Karen Cleofas asking for tugs. Laro Baron asking for BRN. Raven CGC, hello. GNC Cats asking for IDC. Bon Jovi, sabi niya, hello sir. Laro Baron from Laguna, good afternoon. Marie Lizelle Aquino, good afternoon to you too. GNC Cat, good. GN Carlos Sikat. I'm not sure, Mark. I'm Marvin. Karen Cleofas asking for tugs. Ayan, Darby Suanzon, Meg MJ Lim from Bohol asking for. Meg Palmer Salvador asking for AGI, SMPH is from Dubai. Zarlene Tadena asking for tugs. Jodeson Anchetas asking for FNI. Mei Ling Loriga asking for AC. Ali Video SM Prime Holdings. Arkin Cabidas asking for IEC is from Taiwan. Arkin, I hope to see you this December in Taiwan. We have Urgit Peñalosa, good evening to you. A couple of things. For those who watched my PSEI update yesterday, I mentioned that we went above 8,500, but as of closing today, the market wasn't able to hold that 8,500 support level. So it's been elusive, no? But there's one thing that has been relatively evident the past trading day was we broke out from 8,500 yesterday, and it was a feat that has not been done lately. However, as of today also, there was enough selling also to prevent the market from holding 8,500. So for me, that's something very, very significant, because again, without 8,500, our move to 8,800 or our move to 10,000 would not be there in the next few weeks or in the next few months as well. So it's very interesting. Also, a lot of people were asking, bakit bumaba yung market in spite of what's happening? You have to understand this. It will always go back still to people wanting to take profits, and it's not wrong for investors to take profits. It's not wrong also for people who are relatively who have relatively good gains already, or may paglilipatan sila, or they need the money to actually also take money off the table as well. So you have to understand it's part of the cycle. You have to understand also that it's not a question whether markets will go down. It's a question of when it will go down, because it's always part of every cycle, of every movement of the market, to actually retrace and to go down as well. The question now that you must face is that habang bumababa siya, are you the one selling? Are you the one getting out of the stock? Or are you the one suffering a loss? So it will always go back to your plan. That's what I always say, no? The stock market is very, 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 very personal. You must trade based on your own timeline, based on your own risk, and based on the amount of capital that you are also willing to trade. So it always goes back to that, and you must always do it based on the level of tolerance that you can put in, kasi you have to understand also that a 10% loss for someone who has a larger amount of money compared to someone who has a smaller amount of money, there's a different level of exposure there. So that's how you can actually balance your stocks from that perspective. Just a couple of things also from our stocks by request. This is also something that I tallied already from your your questions yesterday, you know, from the things that you started to ask me. So some of the stocks may have moved and continued to go up already today, and some have started to retrace. All right, let's start. I saw a lot of people asking for FNI. Don't worry, FNI will be included in the stocks by request. TUGS will be included in the stocks by request, and also IDC will also be included in the stocks by request session as well. But now let's go first to the ones that had a larger amount of votes. No, our first stock that I'd like to mention is AC. AC, as what I've mentioned in previous videos, is there's still a resistance at 1,100, which our first target price is 1,100. Then as it tried to go to 1,100, hindi siya na break a couple of weeks ago, eh. And then it started to retrace, and yesterday it drew closer to that already. So you have to understand this: it closed at 1,090 yesterday. As it closed at 1,090, it was relatively near our 1,100 target as well. So the drop from AC is pretty much expected from a short term perspective, largely because of the resistance that's there at 1,100. So again, your goal, if you're a quick trader, every time Ali fails to break 1,100, is just to take profits. There's nothing wrong with Ali, it's just that it's a good time for you to take profits and sell at 1,100. If you're a position trader though, let me pull up the chart again. If you're a position trader, the stock still is pretty much in a mid to long term uptrend. There's no sell signal yet if you're a position trader. For quick traders, again, 1,100, anywhere close to 1,100 is your sell signal, and the support is forming for Ayala Corp at 985 pesos per share. So that's it for Ayala Corp. Next stock, let's look at Ayala Land. For Ayala Land naman, Ayala Land, we've mentioned that it's 41 to 46. For trading level for Ayala Land is 41 to 46, no, over the short term. The thing about Ayala Land is it closed at 44, which is still in between our support and resistance level. So no buy signal for the stock if you want to position. However, if you're positioned at the stock, the best time to sell if you're a quick trader, please take profits. If 46 fails, if we fail to break out from 46, you may take profits for Ayala Land. Similar to Ayala Corp, the stock is still in a midterm uptrend. No sell signal for the stock as well. Next, so we've talked about Ayala Corp, we've talked about Ayala Land. Next, another blue chip company. We're gonna talk about BDO. BDO, again, I mentioned it in the previous stocks by request session. You have a resistance at 147. So as stocks draw close to 147, as BDO would draw close to 147, there would be a sell signal already there. It's just good for BDO that in spite of the sell-off note in the afternoon session, BDO held its ground. It's still at 144 pesos per share. But you can expect, no, for those tracking BDO, as long as it does not break past 147 pesos per share, mahirapan yan. If you're a quick trader, BDO fails to break out from 147, take profits. Failure to break out from 147, the stock can retrace to around 132 pesos per share. I repeat, from 147, failure to break out from 147, it may cause BDO to retrace to its short-term support at 132 pesos per share. So since at 144, it's already close to 147, it may be a signal also for you to take profits. If you look at the candle yesterday, no, it drew close already to 147, then intraday it just went lower. So that's one thing to that's a trigger already of certain levels for quick traders, you may already take profits as long as you stick to our principle that 147 is our take profit range if you're a quick trader. Next, so we've talked about Ali, AC, BDO. We're gonna talk about another banking stock, which was BPI. I actually liked the movement of BPI yesterday, no, because of the large bounce with relatively large volume, and that's what I always say in movements, no, anything that has large amounts of volume is something respectable and something that has conviction. However, today BPI closed at 95.6 pesos per share. I repeat, BPI closed at 95.6 pesos per share. What's alarming about that closure at 95.6 pesos per share was that the stock was relatively down 4.16% with 250 billion million value turnover. The thing about that at 95.6 pesos per share is it's what it's floating now at its below its support level. So I repeat, at 95.6 BDO is below its support level. I repeat, at 95.6, BPI is below its support level. The long-term perspective of BPI is it's still bearish, short, mid, and long-term. So position traders, please avoid the stock. Position traders, please stay away from the stock as there's no buy signal yet for BPI in spite of the large move. You have to remember this also. Day-to-day movements do not destroy the trend of the stock. BPI is still bearish. I repeat, BPI is still bearish. The large candle, the large movement that happened yesterday was not strong enough to be able to break the trend. And as a result of that, the downtrend is even progressing even more. It failed to hold the 96.4 support level. Now the stock closed at 95.6. Because of that, a possible retracement of the stock can bring it to around 93 pesos per share. So, quick and position traders, because the stock is in a downtrend, position traders, please stay away from the stock. Because the stock broke down, quick traders, please stay away from the stock as well. Abika Bigas is asking what happened. 8.5 did not hold, so a possible retracement will be 8,300. So, again, what's nice about technicals is it does not forecast the future, but it gives you a risk and reward component on how you're supposed to balance out your trades for the short, mid, and long term, and depending on what your trading agenda is. So AC Ali, BDO, BPI is what we've talked about. The next one, sakto ka Agerico Angulo from Abu Dhabi. You're asking for Mega World. That's our next stock that we're supposed to analyze. So sakto yung pag log in ninyo, sakto. Elaine Canetani is asking for RRHI as well. Let me see Mega World. Mega World yesterday, no, it had a breakout. It broke out from several resistances. However, the large resistance at 5.7, it failed to break out from that. So let me look at the closing price first of Mega World for today. Mega World. Let me check. Hello, Pidlawan. Elizabeth Pidlawan. Good evening. Good afternoon to you from where are you from? I'm just waiting for my browser to log in. Mega World. So Mega World closed at 5.64. It's down 1.05%. Again, Mega World closed at 5.64. It's down 1.05%. Two things. Number one, yesterday Mega World broke out from 5.45 pesos per share. However, there's a resistance at 5.7. Because of the move of Mega World yesterday, it broke out with a large candle at 5.7. The resistance there was strong enough, which you have to remember, the 5.7 resistance, it's one of the strongest resistances that Mega World has had. It's been the resistance since April 2015. So Mega World was trying to break out of a 3-year resistance, which it failed to do. Again, I repeat, Mega World was trying to break out of a 3-year resistance at 5.7, which it failed to break out from. So what happened today was profit taking as the stock hit the 5.7 level resistance. One thing that you should watch out for those who are watching Mega World for the short term is please watch out for the 5.45 level. As long as Mega World stays above the 5.45 level, we're supposed to be okay, we're supposed to be good. The breakout will still continue. I repeat, for those who have your charts open, please put the support level at 5.45. As long as Mega World will stay at 5.45, the shot to break out from 5.7 is still in play. To break out of 5.7, 5.45 is very, 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 very critical that it must hold. If it does not hold, possible retracement to 5.1 is there again over the short term. So those watching Mega World, 5.45. Failure to hold 5.45, stock will drop to 5.1. 5.45, bounce back to 5.45, stock will go up to 5.7, which is the strongest resistance. Breakout from 5.7 will lead the stock to around 6.3, 6.4 over the short term. For position traders, the stock is bullish, short, mid, and long term. So there's no take profit signal yet, that there's no trend reversal yet from a position trading perspective, which is very, very good for those who are watching it from that perspective naman. Next, so we've discussed the PSEI, AC Ali, BDO, BPI, MEG. We're now going to discuss SM Prime Holdings. What I've mentioned in the previous stocks by request session was that there's a resistance at 37 for SMPH, for SM Prime Holdings. And the breakout from 35 was what led to the movement to around 37 pesos per share. So, why am I saying this? Yesterday, the stock successfully broke past 37 pesos per share. I repeat, the stock successfully broke past 37 pesos per share. And today, though, in spite of the heavy selling, SM Prime Holdings is still above. SM Prime Holdings is still above the 37 peso level. It closed at 37.4 pesos per share in spite of it being down 0.40%. So SM Prime is down 0.40%, but it wasn't strong enough to make it drop our 37 peso support level. So interesting enough, there's no sell signal yet for SM Prime Holdings. You have to remember, please watch the 37 peso level clearly, as long as 37 pesos will hold. Short-term traders, quick traders, you have no sell signal yet. I repeat, as long as 37 will hold, we don't have a sell signal yet. Even short-term oscillators are still showing you a more bullish undertone. Again, if 37 though will not hold, a possible retracement to 35 may happen, and the stock will have another short-term sideways movement as what it did nung a couple of weeks back. So, position traders though, trend is still on your side. Long-term, mid-term trend is still on an uptrend. You don't have any sell signal yet. So if you're positioned in SM, no sell signal for both position and quick traders as well. Ayan na. So next, this is what a lot of you guys have been asking. FNI, comment below if you have FNI while you're commenting below. No, I'm here in Petronas Towers. I hug this particular spot. Kaya napapansin nyo, parang walang tao dito, but I just sinolo ko tong spot na to be able to do this Facebook Live session. Kasi if I couldn't do it now already, I think it will be dark later and it will be hard to do a Facebook Live session pag medyo madilim na. So there, gagawin ko lahat. Next week, I'll try to do the Facebook Live session somewhere in Sydney, a good spot. If you can suggest a spot where you want me to do it, I'll try to do it there as well. So what's nice about stock trading is you get to do it anywhere, wherever you are in the world, as long as you have an internet connection, as long as you have a charting software, you'll be able to analyze it, and that's what I like about it. You have Pinky Season asking for SMI Sakto. This is Rochelle Bella from Dubai asking for FNI. Minette Aguilar from Kuwait. GNC Cat asking for IBC. Angerico Angulo, thank you daw. Pinky Season, Veronica Gilido asking for FMI. Ang dami nyo, mostly girls ha, who have FNI right now. So let's pull up the charts as well. Ferro Nickel. So by the way, no, fundamentally speaking, I'm not a big fan of mining companies, because my goal, my style, every time I trade stocks is really is to look at the fundamentals first. The thing about mining companies, they're treated as a commodity. If something is treated as a commodity, you're subjected with a lot of price movements that are above and beyond your control. All right. So FNI closed at 2.97 today. It's up 0.68%. Again, FNI is up 0.68%, which is a stark contrast to the large upswing that it had yesterday. However, what we're looking at yesterday was the breakout. You have to remember this. The movement that we're seeing for FNI is pretty much because of the breakout at 2.8 pesos per share. Again, the movement that we're seeing from FNI is because of the breakout from 2.8 pesos per share. So, for those who are watching FNI, I believe the stock will progress higher as long as the support right now is 2.8 pesos per share. So, people who have FNI, please jot this down. Support is 2.8. As long as 2.8 will hold, there's nothing to worry about. There's no reason for you to sell or take profits. There's no reason to panic. If 2.8 will hold, your target price is around 3.35 or 3.3 pesos per share. So, please jot this down. As long as 2.8 will hold, target price is 3.3 pesos per share. If 2.8 will hold, target price is 3.3. This is around 18% trade ready. So, please watch out for that. If 2.8 does not hold, possible retracement is 2.5. So support now is 2.8. As the stock is up, no need to sell yet. Again, your goal as a stock trader is to hold onto the position as long as there's still an indication that there's a movement upward, and that's what we're seeing. Target price is 3.3 pesos per share. Again, if 2.8 will hold, target price is 3.3. If 2.8 does not hold, retracement to 2.5 pesos is also possible for the stock. Next, We're next talk is we're gonna talk about IDC, and I saw it also here that a lot of you guys talked about or requested about Italpinas, no? The thing about Italpinas is we were talking about IDC with my organizer here in Malaysia, si Hervie, no? She was mentioning that she had a friend that had that with all confidence bought at the very 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 strong support range. So very very nice for you guys who bought it there. So congratulations for those who bought at the strong support. And again, that's where money's made there. When you stick to your technicals, when you stick to your charts, and when you stick to areas where conviction will tell you to buy, and that's when money will be made in the stock. So IDC is up 7.65%. It's at 7.88. The breakout for IDC is the first breakout happened at 5 pesos per share. That was one of the strongest breakouts. Then at 6 pesos ulit, meron ulit siyang breakout doon. So what we're seeing now is just a result of those particular breakouts. The thing about IDC from our perspective, no, it's already higher than its previous high already. So now IDC is already in uncharted territory, meaning there's no resistance for the stock as of this point in time. So why am I saying this? Moving averages, short, mid, and long term are all bullish. So if you're holding on to it, please don't sell yet. Please maximize your gains. Even oscillators, momentum oscillators are still showing bullish momentum upward. Some oscillators are still showing that there's no signal, short-term reversal or sell signals yet. So for those who have IDC, congratulations, no sell signal yet. Hold on to your stock until you have a reversal pattern for the stock. Wag niyo na siya habulin for those that are planning to buy. Please don't chase stocks. I'll say this over and over and over and over and over again. If you're a trader, no, you will always have your time in the sun when the stock will retrace down. So when the stock is hitting highs, please don't buy it already. Please don't chase stocks. The goal in the stock market hasn't changed. It's always buy low, sell high. So if you chase higher prices, you limit the margins that you can get, and you make money when you have relatively good margins if you strategically buy and position well. And the breakout for the stock happened at 5 and it happened at 6 again. But for now, please, if you're positioned, hold, no sell signal yet. For if you plan to buy, please don't chase the stock price anymore. All right, next, Pure Gold. Let's look at Pure Gold. Okay, what was interesting about Pure Gold was this. It's had a bounce now from its support level. So after the bounce from its support level yesterday, it started to go up. But today it's down 1.73% at close at 51.1 pesos per share. Please write this down for Pure Gold. You have a support level at 50.75 pesos per share. You have a support level at 50.75 pesos per share. So as long as Pure Gold stays above 50.75 pesos per share, the move to 55 is still pretty much in play. So Pure Gold is down today, but it closed higher still from the support. It's still higher than the support at 55.75 pesos per share. So you have to remember, even if a stock is down, but as long as the support will hold, there's nothing to worry about, there's nothing to be scared about, there's still a significant level of buying. But please sell if the stock does not hold 50.75. If Pure Gold does not hold 50.75 pesos per share, there's a possible retracement to 47.5 pesos over the short term. So a bounce from 58.75 will bring it back to 55, and that will be your target price for the short term of the stock. Next, position trading. I forgot to mention this. For position traders, the stock is still positionally on an uptrend, so you don't have any sell signal for the stock as of this point in time. Last two stocks before we put this to an end, before we put this to a close, I want to talk about MegaWide. MegaWide is unchanged today, 17.36 pesos per share, relatively unchanged. Value turnover is only 14 billion pesos per share. So let me see MegaWide. So MegaWide, as long MegaWide had a good reversal, no, the strongest resistance kasi for MegaWide was 17.2 pesos per share. Again, the strongest resistance for MegaWide was 17.2 pesos per share, which it broke out from yesterday. I repeat, MegaWide had a strong resistance at 17.2, which it broke out from yesterday. And since it closed higher still than 17.2, which is at 17.36, pretty much the reversal is still intact for the stock. So please note this. Please watch 17.2. If you're a position trader, keep on buying. As long as the stock stays above 17.2, it gives us a notion that the reversal is still pretty much intact. Please avoid the stock if 17.2 does not hold. I repeat, please avoid the stock if 17.2 does not hold. Please don't buy the stock. Please sell if the 17.2 also does not hold. But if 17.2 does hold, initial target price is 18 pesos per share. If 17.2 does hold, continues to go up, target price is 18 pesos per share. If 18 pesos will, if it breaks out from 18, next target price is 18.8. So 17.2 support level, failure to break out from 17.2 will bring it back down to 16. 17.2 support level, failure to hold will bring it back to 16. Breakout from stays above 17.2, target prices is 18. Next target price is 18.8 pesos per share for the stock. And our last stock, ito yung mga hinihintay ng ibang tao. I want to talk about TUGS. Just to recap what we've talked about, we've analyzed the PSEI, ALI, BDO, BPI, MEG, SM Prime Holdings, FNI, IDC, Pure Gold, Megawide, and lastly, TUGS. Alright, Harbor Star. And lastly, also before I close with our last stock, no, just a quick promotion on our events, no. Tomorrow, Stock Smarts Malaysia. Next week, Stock Smarts Sydney. The next week after that, Stock Smarts Qatar. Then we will end November with Stock Smarts Singapore. Then December, Stock Smarts Manila and Taiwan. Then January 2018, CDO and London. Then February, we're coming back to Dubai for Stock Smarts UAE. So wherever you are in the world, we're gonna come to you. We're gonna go to you. The goal of this is just really, this is my passion. I just love talking about stocks. I love sharing it. And traveling also to different countries gives me a vision of what the Philippines can be. You see this? This is also based on the ingenuity of a lot of the Malaysians that are here. But it always makes me sad to see that other countries are doing very well. Don't get me wrong, the Philippine economy is doing well, but we've started relatively slow. But if we want our economy to be as good as London, as Malaysia, as Dubai, as Singapore, as Qatar, and other countries around the world, it's not just really the government, it's not just really foreign investors, but it's us. I really believe that it's entrepreneurs, it's investors like us who will shape the dynamics of the country for the years to come. And it's not about what can the government do for us, it's about what can you do from the capacity of money that you have to change your situation, to change your financial situation, to create businesses, to invest it. Because I really believe this, if you're having a hard time saving money, then don't buy that iPhone 10. But use your money to invest in businesses. Pag kumita yung business, by all means, buy that iPhone 10. When your investments and businesses are doing well, buy as much iPhones as you can, as you want. But until that point in time happens na wala ka pang savings, try to take as much risk in business. Ako, my goal, I'd rather take a risk in an investment that I'm not sure of, na medyo nakakaba at the start, than to spend my money on something na alam ko it will depreciate in the future. People are sometimes scared. People are sometimes scared of taking risk, but at the end of the day, we take a bigger risk when we don't invest at all. We take a bigger risk because time will not be on your side if you're not investing. You have to understand, time is on your side if you start to save and invest as early as possible. And I will continue to say this over and over and over and over again. It's not about how much you put in. It's not about how much you save. It's not about how much you set aside. But it's about how frequent you are in doing it and how disciplined you are. Because if you're disciplined in putting money in, kahit magkamali kayo mag-invest sa stocks, the skill will come in, the experience will come in that will make you better. Your goal is not to play a perfect game when you start investing. Your goal is not to be right all the time, but your goal is to be profitable, that somehow, some way, your investments, your businesses will hit your goals of financial freedom. It can be schooling, it can be retirement, it can be living your life at your own terms. But I hope that it comes to a point that Filipinos get it. That Filipinos get it, that wag na natin i-ask sa ibang tao yung financial freedom natin. Let's not rely on your relatives, let's not rely on a rich neighbor, let's not rely on your boss. You have to understand this, your company, your office won't give you financial freedom. They will give you financial security, they will give you health benefits, health care, they will give you safe and stable job, but they will never give you financial freedom. Financial freedom is something that you take responsibility on your own. Financial freedom is something that you by your own ability, by what God has placed in your heart, you will do by your own accord. So, hindi na to stocks by request, but I just really wanted to share this because for me, at the end of the day, the stock market is useless if it doesn't affect your life. The stock market is useless if it doesn't make you financially free. Kahit anong stocks bilhin nyo, if it, you don't use it to better your lives, if it, kahit anong invest natin, if it doesn't better the next generation of Filipinos, then it's useless. And I hope you get it. And I hope that... And I hope this isn't just videos to all of you, but this is something that makes a difference in your lives. Because that's my heart, eh. My heart is not just to teach you about stocks, but my heart is really to make a difference in your lives. And that's what makes these videos amazing, is that I get to share the things that I'm passionate about. That's why I love this platform that you guys have gave me, because at the end of the day, its influence is just really creating a positive impact in the lives of a lot of Filipinos around us. So lastly, let's talk about TUGS. TUGS closed at 2.83%. TUGS is 1.05% down. However, please note this, the support level for TUGS is 2.15. The movement that you've seen upward was because of the bounce from the 2.15 level last October 17. Again, the movement up of TUGS is because of the bounce from the 2.15 level last October 17. Then secondly, it broke out yesterday from the resistance at 2.7. So in spite of TUGS being down today at 2.85, as long as it stays above 2.7, the breakout is pretty much intact. If there's something that you need to watch out for, is the 2.7 level. The stock will go up still. The stock will break out still, and the stock and oscillators are still showing a bullish undertone as long as it stays above 2.7 pesos per share. If it fails to hold 2.7, the stock may retrace down to 2.15, but unless that happens, there's no need to sell yet as of this point in time. So position traders, no sell signal, the trend is still up, the trend is still bullish, hold your positions. For quick traders, please reference 2.7. if 2.7 will hold, next target price is 3.3 pesos per share. So I repeat this, for those who bought the stock and are holding on to it, if 2.7 will hold, your target price is 3.3 pesos per share. No sell signal yet as of this point in time. From 2.7, if 2.7 does not hold, it can retrace down to 2.1 pesos per share, 2.15 pesos per share, where at that point in time, it's now at the strongest support. So for those who are joining us just now, also, this will be uploaded in marvingermo.com. This will also be uploaded in my YouTube channel as well. So I hope these videos help you, give you a sense of conviction on what's happening in the markets, no, on a regular basis. Because at the end of the day, that's the heart of all of this. That's the heart of why we do these videos. The stocks that we've talked about is AC, Ali, BDO, BPI, Meg, SMPH, FNI, IDC, Pure Gold, Megawide, and TUGS. So that's it. That's it for now. I'm gonna try to do a lot more videos here in Kuala Lumpur. Things that, if you guys appreciate, did you guys like the stocks? I've been doing a series in YouTube. It's called Stock Smarts TV, where I make a lot of basic videos, the things that aren't discussed pretty much in technical and fundamental analysis. But the goal of that also is to, at the end of the day, still educate Filipinos on the proper rudiments of investing. And I really hope that you guys appreciate it, because I'm just going to do more and more and more videos like that. And I hope that even here in Kuala Lumpur, I get to make as much as I can. So, I really want to see as much Filipinos be financially free, and I really want a lot of Filipinos hit their goals of financial freedom. So this ends our stocks by request session. I hope this helps you trade well, trade strong, trade smart. This is Marvin Germo from Kuala Lumpur. I hope you guys have a great day ahead, have a great weekend, and I hope you enjoy your time. God bless you, and good day.